Hello scholars, welcome back to our next video of GK. In our previous video,
we have already completed few exercise of unit 2. So today we will do the rest of the exercises of unit 2. But before that, let me tell you the answer of the question which I have given you as your homework. So the question was, name the only food that does not spoil. The answer is honey. Honey is the only food that truly lasts forever, thanks to its magical chemistry and the handiwork of bees. Now scholars, we will start doing our exercises of the book. So scholars, now we will start our exercise number 13, that is Wondrous World of Birds. Here we have to look at these pictures given, read the description and name the birds. So let's start with our question number 1. These are a type of wedding birds. When born, they are white in color. The pinkish color of their body comes from the food they eat, which includes blue-green algae and brine shrimp. As you can see the picture of the bird also. Can you recognize the bird? Yes, it is flamingo. So here we will write flamingo. Flamingo get their reddish pink color from special coloring chemicals, that is called pigments, found in the algae and invertebrates that they eat. Now we'll move to our question number 2. This endangered bird is the national bird of Philippines. It is considered to be among the largest and most powerful birds in the world. Can you recognize this bird? Our answer is Philippines eagle. The Philippine eagle, also known as the monkey-eating eagle or great Philippine eagle, is an endangered species of eagle of the family Accipitridae, which is endemic to forest in the Philippines. So here we will write Philippines eagle. Now we'll move to our question number 3. The dash roosters are the largest chickens in the world. They can be as tall as a small child. These chickens are bred in the USA. Oh, these are known as Brahma roosters. So here we will write Brahma. The Brahma rooster are the largest chickens in the world. This bird is known for its impressive size and its elegant appearance, and despite its hulking stature, will actually be the most peaceful bird. It is not at all harmful. Now we'll see our question number 4. These birds built beautiful hut-like shelters called bowers. The shelter also has a front lawn which is cleaned and layered with moss. As you can see, it looks like crow, but it is not a crow. It is bow bird. They are renowned for their unique courtship behavior, where males build a structure and decorate it with sticks and brightly colored objects in an attempt to attract a mate. Now we'll move to our question number 5. It is the tallest and the fastest bird in the world. It also lays the largest egg. As you can recognize the bird from the picture given? Yes, it is ostrich. So here we will write ostrich. Now let's see our next question. This large bird of Australia can be very aggressive at times and can attack even humans with its dagger-like claws. This makes it the most dangerous bird in the world. It is cassowary. It is the heaviest bird in Australia and the second heaviest in the world. Like this, we have completed our exercise number 13. Now we will move to our next exercise. So scholars, here is our exercise number 14, Know Your Flowers. Here we will learn about the different types of flowers. Here the pictures of some flowers are given below. We have to match them correctly to their names. So scholars, I want you to do this exercise yourself, as here you just have to recognize the flower and match it with its correct name. Like our first one is chrysanthemum. Do you know which flower is known as chrysanthemum? It is given in point number E here. This is known as chrysanthemum. So in front of one, we will write E. So like this, you have to find out the names of all these flowers and match with their correct name. Okay, so first you will do this yourself, and after completing this, you can check your answer from the PDF given in the link below. Now we will see our next exercise. So scholars, here is our exercise number 15, that is creepy insects. Here we will learn about insects. Insects are invertebrate animals. They have no backbone. Their body is made up of three distinct segments and they have three jointed pairs of legs. That is six legs in all. They are the most numerous animals on the earth. So here in this exercise, we have to read this question about the insects and check the correct answer. So let's start with our question number one. These are very small insects that cannot be seen with naked eyes. They can even pass through the nets installed on doors and windows. It is option B, no-see-ums. So here we will put a right tick in option B. Okay, like this. Now we'll move to our question number 2. This insect is mostly found in the Madagascar and has sparkling wings. Yes, you guess right. It is sunset moth. It is given in option A. So we will put a right tick in option A. The sunset moth was first mistaken as butterfly. This moth has scales on its wings, and when they reflect sunlight, their wings seems to shine. Now we will move to our question number 3. This green or brown insect can jump very far, and it feeds mostly on plants. Can you guess the name? Yes, you are right. It is grasshopper. Put a right tick in option C. Now, let's see our question number 4. This brown nocturnal insect is found everywhere where humans live. It is cockroach. So put a right tick in option C. Now let's move to our next question. This insect looks similar to a twig and is probably the world's longest insect. Can you guess the name? No, it's not cricket. It's stick insect. Please put a right tick in option C, stick insect. It is a very long insect. It measures 640 millimeter with legs fully outstretched and was bred at the Insect Museum of West China. Now we'll see our question number 6. This insect can fly forward, backward, and can even hover in air like a helicopter. Yes, you guessed right. It is dragonfly, the option C. So please put a right tick in option C. They are most agile flyers. They can migrate to any direction across sea, moving in any direction like forward, backward, right and left. Now we will see our question number 7. The swarms of these insects can travel long distances. They destroy the crop wherever they land. It is option B, locusts. Put a right tick here. Recently, we have heard in the news in May month that the swarms of locusts have attacked in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and then in Uttar Pradesh. It is being described as the worst attack in 26 years. They have caused a huge damage in these areas to the crops. So, with this we have completed this exercise. Now we will move to the next page. So, on page number 16, exercise mixed bag first is given. Here in this exercise we will get a mixed type of question. It can be related with anything. So here we have to answer these questions. So let's start with our question number 1. Which cells in our blood fight against germs? It is white blood cells. So right here. Now we'll see our question number 2. Name the author who wrote the books of the Harry Potter series. It is a very famous series. I hope you know the answer. Yes, you are right. It is J.K. Rowling. J.K. Rowling first had the idea for Harry Potter while delayed on a train traveling from Manchester to London King's Cross in 1990. Over the next 5 years, she began to plan out the 7 books of the series. Now we'll see our question number 3. In comic series Richie Rich, what was the name of the Richie Rich's dog? The answer is Dollar. Dollar was the name of that Richie Rich's dog. Now we'll move to our next question. Where did Lord Buddha deliver his first sermon? I hope you know this. This is a very famous question. Yes, in Sarnath. In Sarnath, Varanasi, Lord Buddha delivered his first sermon. Now, our next question is, which is the only planet in our solar system that is not named after any god? The answer is Earth. The name Earth is derived from both English and German words Erde, which means ground. Now we'll see our question number 6. In which state the Statue of Unity is situated? Yes, you are absolutely right. It is in Gujarat. So please write here Gujarat. You know, the Statue of Unity is the tallest statue in the world. Now we'll see our question number 7. Who was the first Asian to receive the Nobel Prize? He is Rabindranath Tagore. The 52-year-old Tagore was awarded the honor in 1913. Now we'll move to our next question. Which liquid is called the universal solvent? Yes, you are absolutely right. It is water. As we all know, the water dissolves more substances than any other liquid. That's why it is known as universal solvent. Now our next question is, Shravanbel Gol, an important pilgrimage site in Jainism, is situated in which state of India? It is in Karnataka. Now we'll move to our question number 10. Which flag contains 5 interlocking rings representing 5 continents? Yes, you are right. It is Olympic flag. The Olympic flag was created in 1913 by Baron de Coubertin. It was first inaugurated in Paris in June 1940. Now we will see our question number 11. Which mythical creature was half horse and half man? It is centaur. It is a creature from Greek mythology with the upper body of a human and the lower body and legs of a horse. Now we'll see our last question. To whom must the President of India address his resignation? To the Vice President of India. So we will write here Vice President of India. So like this we have completed this exercise also. Now as you know, in our every video after doing the exercise of the book, we used to move to our next segment, that is of amazing facts and know your country given. But today we will learn the interesting facts which is given in our book on page number 17 in the heading Tell Me Why. Let's start. So here is our first one. Why is potato called a stem? If you observe a potato closely, you will see a number of nodes and buds on it. These are called eyes of the potatoes. If you leave the potato for a few days, leaves and branches will start to develop from its eyes. This can only happen if the potato is a stem. Roots cannot have buds and nodes. Now we'll see our next one. Why is ginkgo tree called a living fossil? Ginkgo biloba, also known as the maidenhair tree, is one of the oldest species of trees on earth. This tree is considered to be a living fossil as it has continued to exist even after major extinction events. Ginkgo trees can grow about 130 feet tall, live for over 1000 years and have a number of therapeutic properties. They are used in traditional Chinese medicine. Now we'll see our next one. Why do mammals have hairs? Mammals are the only animals with hair. Hair is useful to mammals in many ways. It can take on several different forms, including fur, whiskers, spines, or horns, serving different purposes for different animals. The hair color of many mammals blend with their surroundings and help them to hide from the prey or enemies. Fur helps the mammals to keep warm. It also protects their skin from insects, etc. Now we'll see our next one. Why do female kangaroos have a pouch? Kangaroos belong to a group of mammals known as the marsupials. In marsupials, females have a pouch on their belly where they carry their young ones. When a baby kangaroo is born, it is not fully developed. It is blind, hairless, and very tiny. Immediately after birth, it crawls up into the mother's pouch and attaches itself to one of the nipples and starts feeding on the mother's milk. It remains in the pouch for about 8 months until it is fully developed. So, like this, we have completed this segment also. Now we will move to our segment of current affairs. So, scholars, here is your segment of current affairs. So let's see what is today in this segment. Cabinet approves new education policy. HRD Ministry renamed as Education Ministry. The Union Ministry of Human Resource and Development, that is HRD, has been renamed by Union Cabinet as the Ministry of Education. The official announcement was made by Ramesh Pokhriyal, the Education Minister, on 29 July 2020.
The cabinet chaired by PM Modi has also approved the National Education Policy 2020 to reform the higher education sector. The new education policy aimed at making India global knowledge superpower. So scholars, now let's see your homework.
Scholars, here is a test paper given on page number 21 in your book, which is based on the exercises of unit 1 and 2. You have to solve this test paper and then check your answers from the PDF given in the link below.
So scholars, with this, we come to end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it and you understood it very well. Goodbye scholars, stay safe, stay healthy.